Hello, this is Anders from Robotic Bean, and today I'm going to show you what's new in Sequences 1.4, which brings something we call note conditions to sequences. And there are six types of note conditions, and I'm going to go through them all. The first one is probability, and then you have AB variations, first time condition, you have the fill condition, you have the previous condition, and you have a condition looking at the same step. So let's start with the simple one, probability. I'm going to start by loading a patch here, like that. Very annoying. But we can make it a bit more varied by going to the conditions lane and then just clicking some. You see here, you get a percentage. That's the chance that the note will play. And you can also select all the notes and edit one value, and then all the others will follow. And this is the monophonic case. But what about if you have a chord? Well, we made this design that if you have a chord and then you have, let's say you set that one to, what did I set it to? 20% about, and then another one to 67, and another one to close to 100. Let's do it like this. You will see that they sometimes trigger together and sometimes not. But if you think of this as a chord, you probably want it to either trig all three or trig none of them. So if you set them to the same amount, let's set it to 50% exactly. Now you will see that it never triggers. You see that they will always trigger together or not trigger together. So that's how you handle probability with chords. The second condition I'm going to show you is something we call AB variations, which is that you can set a note to repeat just one out of, let's say, four here. Now we're going to play the second time out of four. So let's see if this works. Doesn't trigger the first. Does trigger the second one. And then doesn't trigger. And you can also do the inverse of that, which is to skip every AB. So let's set this one to three, and then we skip the second one. And with this visualization, you can always see what is happening. You can extend this up to 8 repeats. And this can be a nice way to make a pattern appear to be longer, that you have like a running thing, and then at the 8th time it plays, you do a little extra something. So you can sort of extend patterns this way. The next condition is something called play first time only, and it does exactly that. It just triggers the note the first pass of the pattern. So if we set this one to the opposite, which is skip the first time, if we go back to zero, this one should trig and this one should not trig. Let's see if that works out. And then you will see that since this only skipped the first time, it will play all the remaining times. And this can be useful for, let's say, adding a crash symbol. If you're programming drums, you can add a crash symbol so that each time you switch to this pattern, you will get the crash. Okay, up next we have a condition called fill, and that is also a bit drum-like in it sort of works like a drum fill. So let's take this note and say that this should only play when fill is active. And do the same actually for this one. Okay, so we have this little pattern here. And these do not trig because fill is not active. Okay, how can we activate fill? Well, we can press this button. And you see, as long as we hold this, fill will play. And we can automate this. If we create a track for sequences, we have this in the playback section here, fill. So we can do, say that it's active the second bar. And then if we play it here, doesn't trig. Now it's active. And just as with the others, you can skip when fill is active, sort of like an anti-fill or something. But there is also a third way actually to activate fill, and that is by CV. So if we add something that outputs CV here and connect it to fill in, you see here that it starts blinking sort of in time with this one. Ah, just missed it. Ah. Okay, let's. No, we can't. We'll have to do like this then. Have a real slow LFO. And then. Ah, now you see. No trig and trig. Okay, away with that one. And close this one. And let's start from over and look at the next condition called previous. So let's say we have this note here, and let's say we set it to play every second time. Now it trigs, and now it doesn't trig. And then let's say we want, whenever this one trigs, we want this one to trig. Well, we could set it to the same, but let's say this was a probability, so it's not deterministic. You won't get the same result. Then you can set this one to with previous condition. And this little arrow here looks at the previous condition, and if this turned out to trig, this one will also trig. So this should either be double or no notes. So let's see what's happening. Okay, both. None. And you can also stack notes or have them in you can have a sequence of notes that are all with previous condition. And this will all look at this one. They won't look, the second one won't look at the first previous condition. All four previous conditions evaluate this one. So if we start. And this is pretty nice that you can sort of group, these notes are now grouped like a phrase, so you can either trig it, and if you set this to, let's say, fill, you can have this running and they won't trig, but if you make fill active, you will also get the little phrase. Okay, moving on. We have reached the last condition, which is called same step. And this is a bit like the previous condition, but here it looks at any condition in the same step. So if we have this note again, we set it to play every second time, you can add another note and set it to with the condition in the same step. And let's do a, can we do a full chord here? So now we should either get a full chord or nothing. And this can actually be used to have alternating chords in the same step. So let's say we make another chord here. We start at F. This is F, right? And we make all these into not with condition in the same step. And then we move them here. Then whenever either the C chord plays, because this turned out true, or the F chord plays because this turned out false. So let's see what's happened. You get C, F, C, F. And that can be pretty nifty. But while testing this, we found out that you often get chords that are stacked like this. So we added this little counter so that you can see how many notes are stacked in this position. Now you see you have three notes here. Let's move that one away. So this helps a bit, but we also found out a trick that I want to share with you. And that is that you can take your alternating chord. You see you have the C, and then we have the F, and then we have the A. And you can move them up one octave. And then you can go to the octave lane and pitch them down one octave. So now we actually have, here is the C chord, here is the F chord, but they will sound in the same octave range, I hope, if we do this correctly. C, F. So that is a little trick. Okay, so we have talked about probabilities, AB variations, playing first time, playing during fail, looking at the previous condition, and looking at the condition in the same step. And that's about it. So hope you enjoyed this update, and see you in the next time. Bye bye.